Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your rising. Dearly beloved, the scriptures teach us to acknowledge our many sins and offenses, not concealing them from our Heavenly Father, but confessing them with humble and obedient hearts, that we may obtain forgiveness by his infinite goodness and mercy. We ought at all times humbly to acknowledge our sins before Almighty God, but especially when we come together in his presence, to give thanks for the great benefits we have received at his hands, to declare his most worthy praise, to hear his holy word, and to ask for ourselves and on behalf of others those things which are necessary for our life and our salvation. Therefore, draw near with me to the throne of heavenly grace. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess your faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun, and our eyes behold the Vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. My song shall be always of the loving kindness of the Lord. With my mouth will I ever be proclaiming your faithfulness from one generation to another. For I have said, mercy shall be built up forever. Your faithfulness shall be established in the heavens. I have made a covenant with my chosen one. I have sworn to David, my servant. Your seed will I establish forever and set up your throne from one generation to another. O Lord, the heavens will praise your wondrous works and your faithfulness in this assembly, in the assembly of the saints. For who in the clouds can be compared unto the Lord, and who among the gods is like unto the Lord? God is greatly to be feared in the council of the saints, and to be held in reverence by all those who are round about him. O Lord God of hosts, who is like you? Your faithfulness, most mighty Lord, is round about you. You rule the raging of the sea. You still the waves when they arise. You have subdued Rahab of the deep and destroyed her. You have scattered your enemies with your mighty arm. The heavens are yours. The earth also is yours. You laid the foundation of the world and all that is in it. You have made the north and the south. Tabor and Hermon shall rejoice in your name. You have a mighty arm, strong is your hand, and high is your right hand. Righteousness and justice are the foundation of your throne. Mercy and truth shall go before your face. Blessed are the people, O Lord, who rejoice in you. They shall walk in the light of your countenance. Their delight shall be in your name all the day long, and in your righteousness shall they make their boast. For you are the glory of their strength, and by your favor you shall lift up our might. For the Lord is our defense, the Holy One of Israel is our King. You spoke in a vision to your saints and said, I have set the crown upon one who is mighty. I have exalted one chosen out of the people. I have found David my servant. With my holy oil have I anointed him. My hand shall hold him fast, and my arm shall strengthen him. My enemy shall not be able to do him violence. The son of wickedness shall not hurt him. I will smite his foes before his face and strike down those who hate him. My faithfulness and my mercy shall be with him, and in my name shall his horn be exalted. I will give him dominion over the sea, and with his right hand shall he rule the rivers. He shall say to me, You are my Father, my God, and the rock of my salvation, and I will make him my firstborn higher than the kings of the earth. My mercy will I keep for him forever, and my covenant shall stand fast with him. His seed will I make to endure forever, and his throne as the days of heaven. But if his children forsake my law and do not walk in my judgments, if they break my statutes and do not keep my commandments, I will punish their offenses with the rod and their sin with scourges. Nevertheless, my loving kindness I will not utterly take from him, nor suffer my faithfulness to fail. My covenant I will not break, nor alter the word that has gone out of my lips. I have sworn once by my holiness, that I will not fail David. His seed shall endure forever, and his throne as the sun before me. It shall endure for evermore as the moon, and as the faithful witness in the cloud, in the heavens. But you have rejected and forsaken your anointed. You are full of wrath against him. You have broken the covenant with your servant. You have defiled his crown and cast it to the ground. You have overthrown all his walls and broken down his strongholds. All those who go by plunder him, and he has become a reproach to his neighbors. You have exalted the right hand of his enemies and made all his adversaries rejoice. You have turned back the edge of his sword and have not given him victory in the battle. You have taken away his glory and cast his throne down to the ground. The days of his youth you have shortened and covered him with dishonor. Lord, how long will you utterly hide yourself? How long shall your wrath burn like fire? Oh, remember how short my time is. Why have you made all people for naught? What man is there who lives and sees not, and shall not see death, and shall deliver his soul from the power of the grave? Lord, where are your loving kindnesses of old, which you swore to David in your faithfulness? Remember, Lord, how your servants are reproached, and how I bear in my bosom the rebukes of many people. Remember how your enemies have reproached you, O Lord. Praised be the Lord forevermore. Amen and amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the book of Jeremiah, beginning with the 47th chapter, the first verse. The word of the Lord that came to Jeremiah the prophet concerning the Philistines before Pharaoh struck down Gaza. Thus says the Lord, behold, waters are rising out of the north, and shall become an overflowing torrent. They shall overflow the land and all that fills it, the city and those who dwell in it. Men shall cry out, and every inhabitant of the land shall wail at the noise of the stomping of the hooves of his stallions, at the rushing of his chariots, at the rumbling of their wheels. The fathers look not back to their children, so feeble are their hands because of the day that is coming to destroy all the Philistines, to cut off from Tyre and Sidon every helper that remains. For the Lord is destroying the Philistines, the remnant of the coastline of Kaphtor. Baldness has come upon Gaza. Ashkelon has perished. O remnant of their valley, how long will you gash yourselves? Ah, sword of the Lord, how long till you are quiet? Put yourself into your scabbard. Rest and be still. How can it be quiet when the Lord has given it a charge against Ashkelon and against the seashore? He has appointed it. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Glory to you, Lord God of our fathers. You are worthy of praise. Glory to you. Glory to you for the radiance of your holy name. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. Glory to you in the splendor of your temple. On the throne of your majesty, glory to you. Glory to you seated between the cherubim. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. Glory to you, beholding the depths and the high vault of heaven. Glory to you. Glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. A reading from St. Paul's Epistle to the Romans, beginning with the second chapter, the first verse. Therefore you have no excuse, O man, every one of you who judges. For in passing judgment on another you condemn yourself, because you, the judge, practice the very same things. We know that the judgment of God rightly falls on those who practice such things. Do you suppose, O man, you who judge those who practice such things and yet do themselves, that you will escape the judgment of God? Or do you presume on the tricks of his kindness? Or do you presume on the riches of his kindness and forbearance and patience, not knowing that God's kindness is meant to lead you to repentance? But because of your hard and impenitent heart, you are storing up wrath for yourself on the day of wrath, when God's righteous judgment will be revealed. He will render to each one according to his works. To those who are led, to those who by patience in well-doing, seek for glory and honor and immortality, he will give eternal life. But those who But for those who are self-seeking and do not obey the truth, but obey unrighteousness, there will be wrath and fury. There will be tribulation and distress for every human being who does evil, the Jew first and also the Greek. But glory and honor and peace for everyone who does good, the Jew first and also the Greeks. For God shows no partiality. For all who have sinned without the law will also perish without the law. And all who have sinned under the law will be judged by the law. For it is not the heavens of the law. For it is not the hearers of the law who are righteous before God, but the doers of the law who will be justified. For when Gentiles who do not have the law by nature do what the law requires, they are a law to themselves, even though they do not have the law. They show that the works of the law is written on their hearts, while their conscience also bears witness, and their conflicting thoughts accuse or even excuse. Accuse or even excuse them. On that day when, according to my gospel, God judges the secrets of men by Christ Jesus. But if you call yourself a Jew and rely on the law and boast in God, and know his will and approve what is excellent, because you are instructed from the law, and if you are sure that you yourself are a guide to the blind, a light to those who are in darkness, an instructor of the foolish, a teacher of children, having in the law the embodiment of knowledge and truth, you then, who teach others, do you not teach yourself? While you preach against stealing, do you steal? You who say that one must not commit adultery, do you commit adultery? You who abhor idols, do you rob temples? You who boast in the law, dishonor God by breaking the law. For as it is, the name of God is blasphemed among the Gentiles because of you. For circumcision indeed is of value if you obey the law, but if you break the law, your circumcision becomes uncircumcision. So if a man who is uncircumcised keeps the precepts of the law, will not his uncircumcision be regarded as circumcision? Then he who is physically uncircumcised but keeps the law will condemn you who have the written code and circumcision but break the law. For no one is a Jew who is merely one outwardly, nor is circumcision outward and physical. But a Jew is one inwardly, and circumcision is a matter of the heart, by the Spirit, holy. But a Jew is one inwardly, and circumcision is a matter of the heart, by the Spirit, not by the letter. His praise is not from man, but from God. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Lord, now let your servant depart in peace according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles and to be the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. I believe he will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, show your mercy upon us and grant us your salvation. O Lord, guide those who govern us and lead us in the way of justice and truth. Clothe your ministers with righteousness and let your people sing with joy. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Give peace in our time, O Lord, and defend us by your mighty power. Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and take not your Holy Spirit from us. Almighty God, through the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, you reveal the way of eternal life to every race and nation. Pour out this gift anew, that by the preaching of the gospel, your salvation may reach to the ends of the earth through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, by your death you took away the sting of death. Grant to us, your servants, so to follow in faith where you have led the way, that we may at length fall asleep peacefully in you and wake up in your likeness, for your tender mercy's sake. Amen. O God, the Father, creator of heaven and earth, have mercy upon us. O God, the Son, redeemer of the world, have mercy upon us. O God, the Holy Spirit, sanctifier of the faithful, have mercy upon us. O Holy, blessed, and glorious Trinity, one God, have mercy upon us. Remember not, Lord Jesus, our offenses, nor the offenses of our forebears, neither reward us according to our sins. Spare us, good Lord, spare your people, whom you have redeemed with your most precious blood, and by your mercy preserve us forever. Spare us, good Lord, from all evil and wickedness, from sin, from the works and assaults of the devil, from your wrath and everlasting condemnation. Good Lord, deliver us from all blindness of heart, from pride, vanity, and hypocrisy, from envy, hatred, and malice, and from all lack of charity. Good Lord, deliver us from all disordered and sinful affections, and from all the deceits of the world, the flesh, and the devil. Good Lord, deliver us from all false doctrine, heresy, and schism, from hardness of heart and contempt of your word and commandments. Good Lord, deliver us from lightning and tempest, from earthquake, fire, and flood, from plague, pestilence, and famine. Good Lord, deliver us from all oppression, conspiracy, and rebellion, from violence, battle, and murder, and from dying suddenly and unprepared. Good Lord, deliver us. By the mystery of your holy incarnation, by your holy nativity and submission to the law, by your baptism, fasting, and temptation, good Lord, deliver us. By your agony and bloody sweat, by your cross and passion, by your precious death and burial, good Lord, deliver us. By your glorious resurrection and ascension, by the sending of the Holy Spirit, by your heavenly intercession, and by your coming again in power and great glory, good Lord, deliver us. In our times of tribulation, in our times of prosperity, in the hour of death, and in the day of judgment, good Lord, deliver us. We sinners beseech you to hear us, O Lord God, that I may please you to rule and govern your holy church universal in the right way. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to illumine all bishops, priests, and deacons with true knowledge and understanding of your word, and that both by their preaching and living they may show it accordingly. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to send forth laborers into your harvest, to prosper their work by your Holy Spirit, to make your saving health known unto all nations, and to hasten the coming of your kingdom. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give all your people increase of grace, to hear your word with humility, to receive it with pure affection, and to bring forth the fruit of the Spirit. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bring into the way of truth all who have erred and are deceived. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give us a heart to love and fear you, and diligently to keep your commandments. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and keep all your people. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, that it may please you to rule the hearts of your servants, our national leaders, and all others in authority, that they may do justice and show mercy and walk humbly before you. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and guide all judges, giving them grace to execute justice and to maintain truth. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and keep our armed forces by sea and land and air, and to shield them in all dangers and adversities. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to bless and protect all who serve their communities by their labor and learning. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to give and preserve for us and for others the bountiful fruits of the earth, so that at the harvest we all may enjoy them. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to make wars to cease in all the world, and to give to all nations unity, peace, and concord. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, that I may please you to show mercy on all prisoners and captives, refugees, the homeless and the hungry, and all those who are desolate and oppressed. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to preserve all who are in danger by reason of their work or travel. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to strengthen the bonds of those in holy matrimony, to uphold the widowed and abandoned, and to comfort all whose homes are torn by strife. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to protect the unborn and their parents, and to preserve all women in childbirth. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to care for those who have lost children or face infertility, and to provide for young children and orphans. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to visit the lonely and those who grieve, to strengthen all who suffer in mind, body, or spirit, and to comfort with your presence those who are failing and infirm. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to support, help, and deliver all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to have mercy upon all people. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, that it may please you to give us true repentance, to forgive us all our sin, negligence, and ignorance, and to endue us with the grace of your Holy Spirit, to amend our lives according to your holy word. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and to turn their hearts. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to strengthen those who stand, to encourage the faint-hearted, to raise up those who fall, and finally to beat down Satan under our feet. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord, to grant to all the faithful departed eternal life and peace. We beseech you to hear us, good Lord. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. Son of God, we beseech you to hear us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us your peace. O Christ, hear us. O Christ, hear us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. O God, we have heard with our ears, and our forebears have declared to us the noble works that you did in their days and in the time before them. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O Lord, arise and help us, and deliver us for your name's sake. From our enemies, defend us, O Christ. Graciously behold our afflictions. With pity, behold the sorrows of our hearts. Mercifully forgive the sins of your people. With favor, hear our prayers. O Son of David, have mercy upon us. Be pleased to hear us, O Christ. Graciously hear us, O Christ. Graciously hear us, O Lord Christ. Let us pray. Look mercifully, O Father, on our infirmities, and for the glory of your name, rescue us from all those evils we now endure, and grant that in all our troubles we may put our whole trust and confidence in your mercy, serving you in holiness and purity of life, to your honor and glory through our only mediator and advocate, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplications to you, your promise. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than what we can ask or imagine. Glory to him from generation to generation, in the church and in Christ Jesus, forever and ever. Amen.